Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy, and we're talking about slope, and in this case we're talking about how to find the slope when your equation is in slope-intercept form. Slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. We just talked about slope is abbreviated with the letter m, so when you're in slope-intercept form, the slope is the coefficient of your x term. It's right there next to your x. The y-intercept is b. And so that's what you get at the end. And we're not as interested in this lecture about the B, but we want to talk about it because B is always your y-intercept. That is, where does it cross the y-axis? So you can see your slope and where it crosses the y-axis in this format. We don't have to do any computation to see the slope. So in this particular equation, y equals negative 5x plus 2. That is in slope-intercept form. Y is by itself, followed by the x term, and then a number at the end. If that didn't have a number, that just means the number would be 0, so it's okay if it just has this term. What does the slope mean, and what is the slope? Well, the slope in this equation is right here. The slope is negative 5, not negative 5x, but just negative 5. So m equals negative 5. What does the slope mean? Well, when you have a negative slope, that slope means it represents something that is going down or decreasing. So that negative means we have a decreasing function. Function is just another term we can use when we talk about linear equations. We have something that's going down. So I could say for this equation, like, what does this mean? Well, remember, B is the y-intercept or the starting point. So I could say the temperature was 2 degrees, but fell by 5 degrees each hour. It started off at 2, that's the starting point, and then it fell, because it's negative, it fell by 5 degrees each hour. That's one thing I could say to explain this function. Okay. We could also say they started off with $2 and lost $5 a month. That means you're going into debt, right? But we can always talk about a negative as something that's falling or decreasing every month. Okay, so then number 2, y equals 12x plus 3. What's the slope in this equation? There's two numbers that we have to think about, the 12 and the 3. The slope is always that number that's next to the x. So the slope here is 12. So what does this equation mean? Does it mean she started with 12 and increased her client number by 3 each month? Or she started with 3 and increased her client number by 12 each month? And I'm just randomly putting something to that equation because sometimes when it's so abstract, it's hard to think, what am I actually looking at there? This is an explanation of something. This tells you a story, more or less. And so which one is it? Well, 12 is what's the rate of change, okay? That's what slope is. It's a rate of change. And that might be important to write down. Slope is a rate of change. That's what's happening every month, okay? Well, she's not changing by 3 each month. She's changing by 12 each month. 3 would be her starting point. This number at the end, the y-intercept, that's a starting point. So she started with 3 and then increased her client number by 12 each month. That's the description that makes sense for this equation. Starting at 3 and increasing by 12 every month. In this case, it's positive slope, so she's increasing. In the last one we saw, it was a negative slope, so they were decreasing or falling. That's an important thing about negative and positive. Okay, try number 3 on your own. To first of all decide what the equation slope is, and then decide which one of these statements makes sense. Okay, the slope is the number next to the x. It's the coefficient of the x term, and that slope is 4. So your slope is 4. Okay, which one of these would fit this equation? He had $120 of debt, but paid it off $4 a week. Or after 4 weeks, he was $120 in debt. Well, no. He started off at negative 120. So he had a debt of 120 to start with. He's coming out of debt because he's paying $4 every week. And we don't know, week, month. I'm just making up a scenario to go with this. But it makes sense. The starting point, he was actually in the hole to start with, and he's coming out. Eventually, he will come out of debt, right? Like 28 weeks or whatever it is. Or 29, I don't even want to guess. Okay, I can't remember. 25 plus 5 more. 30 weeks. 30 weeks he's out of debt, right? So it's A, he had $120 of debt but paid it off $4 a week, okay? Mental math is important. I'm sorry, mine is a little weak right there. Okay, one more. Try this one. What's the slope? And then which one of these equations, one statement, could match up to this equation in meaning? Well, the slope is negative 1/2 because our coefficient of x is the slope. Notice the slope doesn't include the x. It's the number next to the x. And it's a rate of change. By this rate of change being negative, we're talking about growing hair. Since it's a negative, was she growing hair or was she cutting hair? Are we getting more or are we getting less? Well, it's negative, so there's actually a decrease. What was the starting point of her hair? Well, she had hair that was 12 inches long. Her hair was 12 inches long and she grew a half an inch a month. No, if she was growing a half an inch a month, we would have a positive 1/2, right? So that's not it. Her hair was 12 inches long and she cut a half an inch per month. Yes, every month she's cutting a half an inch off. And just side note, people typically grow a half an inch a month, so she would just kind of keep her hair the same if she was an average person. Okay, that's the idea of finding the slope when you have slope-intercept form, and also talking about what is the meaning of these equations and what would that look like in a real-life scenario.